Okay, so now we're visiting, it's called the Monkey Temple. We have a boy here who's going to help us, protect us from the monkeys. We have a lot of monkeys, but he's studying Sanskrit. And in his spare time, he shows people around the temple here. We're just entering the temple here. It's a Hindu temple. And they believe that monkeys, they're sacred. Just as they do with cows as well, also sacred. And Krishna is the god of the cows, but here we have the god of the monkeys. They also believe that feeding the monkeys is good for their soul.
Dedicated to the monkey god, and his name is Hanuman.
Yes.
And that is the green one you can see on the corner. That's the monkey god.
Okay, the green one is the monkey god. Okay. Okay, Jamie's having a course in how to deal with monkeys.
Yes, higher. Keep your hand right there. He'll come and get that. Just wait. Wait, we'll come and get that.
Busy,
yeah.
Are
you finished for? There you go, he's coming now.
There
you go.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Now it's okay. I'll
look impressed.
Yeah, exactly.
Sir,
it's your turn.
Daddy.
Yeah,
look at that.
Now Daddy has a monkey, real monkey, on his hand. And it's a white one.
Are you hungry today, monkey?
They believe that the monkeys are a reincarnation of the monkey god Hanuman.
Hanuman.
Yes. And there's about 60 monks living here in the temple. That's another fact.
Here. This one is actually for the monkeys. The monkeys, they used to live here in the forest. That's the reason they built the temple here. It's built in the 15th century. And then the next pool is for men. And then there's a pool. Oh, there's a monkey in the way now. And there's a pool a little bit further down for women. Can we see the pool, monkey? Yes, thank you. Yeah, you can see the pool for men. And the one at the lower one is for women. This water actually flows from the Ganges under the through the mountains, and then it emerges here. Okay, it's not flowing at the moment. So, just asking why there's a barbed wire here, which led to quite an astonishing fact that actually 1,000 people have committed suicide and died in this pool here. And so that's the reason. So they're not jumping, climbing over the fence here. And I asked her, when was the last one? The last one was only 5 days ago. She climbed actually over there with the monkeys and jumped into the pool here, and he couldn't swim. Completely shocking, really. You can see people are swimming here actually today, but until the steel rail there, it's only 3 meters. After that it gets very deep, 20 meters deep. So they believe the water here is holy. That's also the reason why they commit suicide in this water here. They believe if they commit suicide in holy water, they will go to heaven. That's one of the beliefs they have here. Monkeys everywhere here. We have the women's pool and a very beautiful view of the temple. India is a country you love and hate both at the same time. One of the things that we love is going to a place like this. You can get two samosas, a few snacks, and it costs hardly any money, really nice and cheap, much cheaper than McDonald's.
We enjoyed the monkey temple more than we thought we would. I thought it was just like some abandoned temple that was taken over by monkeys, but it was actually still a temple that was working, and there was monks living there, and students studying to be priests. Our guide there was very good. He was had been there for 5 years now, studying to become a priest, and he had to be there for 2 years more. It was not his own choice, it's his parents that has said that he should be there. So that's very different. But he was a very good guy, and we really enjoyed it, seeing the temple a lot.
Yeah.
Very nice, situated in the mountains. Unfortunately not maintained again, but he said that's because that the owner of the temple is privately owned. He just wanted to be restored or painted.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. A bit different the way we think. It would be so beautiful if it was all renovated. But no, that's the way it is. It looks like some kind of a film set. And I asked if it was used as a film set. He says yes, many times. So yeah, maybe if we're watching some films in the future, we may spot the monkey temple. So that was good. We will enjoy our samosas. Okay. This will be the last place we see here in Jaipur. It's been recommended to us again by the hotel. He said it's one of the best places in Jaipur, even though it's underrated. Not many people come here. It's called Gaitore. So actually the place where the Rajasthan kings are cremated here. So that's going on. It's the creation monuments. Bodies aren't here because they're being cremated at the Rajasthan kings. Extremely beautiful carved buildings here.
My wife, my home. So this is peaceful and quiet palace. Shanti, Shanti. This king name, Madhav Singh first. Two Madhav Singh. This is first Madhav Singh, first part, second Madhav.
Well, this is the monument of Jai Singh, the man that made the observatory yesterday, also the founder of the city. He was cremated here. And they later built the monument around the place where he's cremated. Extremely beautifully carved in marble here.
Okay, the interesting thing here is actually they have you can see the teeth of the actually horses. That means how good they actually have designed the things. You can actually see where the horse have teeth is, and you can see the hair and all sorts and everything, and the peacock and everything.
You can see in the center, this is where he was cremated, and then the ashes are later on put inside.
The guy just told us a story about the king that was cremated here. He was very tall and very big and weighed 250 kilos. And he had 900 girlfriends because none of them could survive a night with him. So gruesome story if it's true.
Pink City. This will be the last time we're here. Okay, so that's the end of our 4 days here in Jaipur. We only planned to stay 2 days, but yeah, we enjoyed it so much here, and there was quite a lot to do here, so we stayed an extra 2 days. So we're just taking it day by day, what we've been doing so far in India, and just making it up as we go along, listening to what people tell us and had different advice. So that's what we've been doing here. So there's been quite a lot to see here. The city's divided into two. You have the old part, which is the pink city. That's where we've been quite most of the time. That's where we're filming a lot. So it seems a very old city, but there's also a newer part of the city. That's where our bed and breakfast is here. But most of the attractions there in the old city, that's what you've been seeing most of the time. There was quite a lot to do there, so could easily fill 4 days here with sightseeing and different activities. And Jamie's been playing football as well, so that's good. Another great thing about this place is this bed and breakfast that we found here, Bowan, I think it's pronounced. That's really been a great place that we found, probably one of the best places. So, but mainly because of the owners, just how hospitable and kind and friendly they are and helpful. It's actually the only place we've stayed in where the owners actually have breakfast with the guests. So we managed to sit together with them every morning, and they're giving us great advice on places to go, but not only that, just nice conversation, talking about India and all the places we've been. And yeah, so that was actually a great experience and a great thing that they take the time just to sit and talk to us. And so we managed to learn even more here about India. So a great place, great bed and breakfast. That was a great place. I know they're expanding now, so they have a few rooms, and I think in a month they're opening another hotel on the other side of the road, and have plans for even more things with the yoga retreat kind of thing. So yeah, probably won't be anything like this in 10 years time, but we really enjoyed it here, so that was great. But tomorrow we're back on the move again. We're leaving Jaipur early in the morning, so we'll be going to the airport, then we'll be flying to Mumbai, and then from Mumbai we'll be flying to Goa. And then we just booked one night in a hotel down there, and then so in a place called Paloem. It's near the beach, so we'll be staying there one night, then we'll have the next day, we'll be going around and trying to find a place to stay, maybe somewhere near to the beach. We'll see what it's like down there. Don't think the weather looks too good, but we'll see. What we really want to do down there is try some yoga and learn more about that. That's something new. It's not just about different postures and exercises as it is in Europe. Here it's more spiritual and learning also. So that'll be good if we can do that. Not sure whether we can yet. Well, we'll see. That's what we hope to do. But, so that's it. Yeah, tomorrow we're back on the move. So we'll see you tomorrow in the airport. Not sure how much we'll film tomorrow. I think it's just a traveling day. But we'll see. Okay, bye-bye. Jugni, 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 jugni